truth on this one. We turn to another aspect of the Obama administration and its so-called hit list. Yes, our president has a hit list of American citizens like you targeted for assassination. Now, I want you to imagine George W. Bush had a hit list of Americans targeted for assassination. This president does, and there are indications that the list of Americans targeted for assassination is growing. The CIA's list included three people, apparently, just a few months ago, but in a recent interview with the Washington Times, President Obama and his top terrorism advisor, John Brennan, said there are dozens of U.S. citizens around the world that are, quote, very concerning to the administration. Brennan also making two distinctions about who would, quote, face the brunt of the U.S. military response. Group one, a U.S. citizen found on the battlefield in Afghanistan or Iraq attacking U.S. forces. That's makes sense. Group two, a U.S. citizen in Yemen or Pakistan or Somalia or some other place attacking U.S. forces. It is unclear, however, if the dozens Brennan mentioned are on that list. But as Salon.com's Glenn Greenwald puts it, Brennan's statement suggests that the president's battlefield powers extend everywhere, even to places where there is actually no combat whatsoever. And joining us now, Salon.com's Glenn Greenwald. Glenn, how do you interpret this? I won't even subject you to a bunch of questions. So you look at this, is this as bad as it appears?
It's probably worse than it appears. I mean, look at the controversies that were created during the Bush administration when the president got caught spying on American citizens without warrants or trying to detain them without due process. Here you're talking about something far more extreme. You're talking about targeting American citizens for murder, for assassination, based merely on the allegation that they're involved in terrorism. No evidence, no charges, no trial, nothing. And it's extraordinarily dangerous, especially when you consider the fact that when allegations of terrorism by the government are subjected to judicial review, in overwhelmingly high percentages of the cases, 72%, courts find that the allegations are without merit. So who would ever justify allowing the president to target American citizens for assassination without any judicial oversight or charges or due process of any kind?
Do you believe that if this was President George W. Bush, who was widely distrusted and disliked by a huge percentage of the American population by the end of his term, as opposed to the current president, who is laden with lots of hope and aspiration and lots of grand ideas that many people feel he articulates very well, and yet his actions create a massive cognitive dissonance that actually allows him to get away with more than George W. Bush could when it comes to encroachments on civil liberties, facilitating theft from the American people, or potentially calling you or me a terrorist and trying to have us killed?
Well, I know that that's the fact. I mean, the Republicans are at least being consistent. When Bush was president, they said, we think the president should be able to have whatever powers he wants in an unchecked fashion, as long as it's justified by terrorism and war. The Democrats, though, said that they were against those things, that the president shouldn't have powers to exercise in an unchecked fashion. And again, if you look at what Democrats, including Barack Obama, objected to, it was merely things like eavesdropping on Americans and detaining them without due process and without charges. And now Democrats have completely abandoned those objections now that there's a Democrat in the White House, and apparently not just detaining and eavesdropping Americans, but targeting them for murder is acceptable to the Democratic Party now that there's a Democrat in the White House. And again, if you justify that, targeting American citizens for assassination without any due process, what don't you approve of?
Are you surprised at the media's lack of an outroar relative to this when you consider what it might have been if George W. Bush did the exact same thing quickly?
Well, I think the media wasn't really particularly all that upset about what Bush did either. And I think the problem is that if you justify something with the word terrorism, it scares the media, and they're afraid to appear sympathetic to terrorism by opposing it. And what they have to get back to is the basic rights and constitution that say that political leaders in the United States cannot exercise power in an unchecked way.
Glenn, sing it loud, sing it proud. Thank you so much for speaking in public and speaking truth. And again, we invite debate, both myself and Glenn, on any of these issues. We don't try to present it. I don't try to present it. I know Glenn doesn't, as point of view, but as point of fact, and invite any debate on any of these issues. Glenn, thank you so much for your time.